this a little bit, rather than doing a whisper. You know, I'm kind of a bit of a, you know, I like to keep things mixed up and kind of fresh a little bit and impromptu. So just kind of feel like whispering tonight a little bit. So we're just going to do this format a little bit. And I also got a piece of gum. I know some of you enjoy the sounds of sessions still in within the ASMR realm and just mix things up a little bit. Maybe kind of have some kind of trigger or other kind of relaxing sound in the background. I thought about having the sound of a creek. Psychoactive, we have gambling, of course sex, video games, even exercise, or over-exercise. What if you go out as I don't need a drink every night. I know when to stop. So I wonder, the same thing with cigarettes. I used to smoke cigarettes. I used to smoke marijuana. I stopped about 2 years before the birth of our son, when I knew that we were going to get ready to have a son. I wanted to have, you know, my body in a healthiest state as possible. I've given up cigarettes for life. I can't say that about any other psychoactive plant. Right now, it's illegal to do drugs or to ingest certain psychoactive plants here in the United States, so I don't condone that. And again, I'm not just saying that I don't partake of any of those substances, which are just plants. But that's an entirely another video, which we'll probably be doing next after this one, because that's a very interesting topic as well. So I used to smoke. I could never smoke more than two or three cigarettes a day, because much less more than two at a time, unless I was drinking socially, because I would get nauseous. My body would just be like, no, you can't smoke anymore. I would get nauseous, and I could never understand how some people can smoke a pack of cigarettes a day. That just baffles me, just physically, because, like I said, I'm not trying to talk down to those people. You know, I sympathize, and I understand how they could possibly do that. I'm just saying my body could never handle more than like two or three cigarettes a day, maybe four. But honestly, so I wonder if there probably is some genetics involved, and maybe not just genetics, but some kind of, you know, to a degree, a mental state, or something, and I don't mean chemically, I just mean, you know, maybe there's something in the mind, thoughts, or depression, or some kind of, you know, something more than just a biological genetic reason, that leads someone, who makes someone more susceptible to becoming an addict. Because, like I said, I've smoked marijuana, I've smoked tobacco cigarettes, I drink, and I'm not addicted, so I know part of that is self-control. Maybe that's part of the reason. Maybe some people have a hard time with that. Again, that could be some genetics there. But beyond that, we have the video games, and I'm pretty certain that the internet and computers are very much like a drug. How many people stay up late, and I'm sure you know who you are, you know, past midnight, you know, getting, you know, no, to 2 o'clock in the morning, either playing a video game or just trying to find something to do, because you don't want to go sleep and you're on the computer and you're just surfing and you're just fiddling around. And the computer stimulates the mind, and it's an addiction, I think, to a degree. You know, it keeps your mind awake, like a drug, I think. So, but it's, you know, that's like a iffy kind of subject. Video games, for sure. Me and my son, we'll play video games together. And sometimes we'll just keep it to 15 or 20 minutes, because he's getting older now. He's almost 6. gotta get off. It's just time to go, you know, play or do something else. Or that's enough. He'd break down and cry. And I've heard that story from other parents. And so that's the video game messing with, you know, people's minds. It's a stimulant. So, but if I limit him, my son, to 15 minutes or something, a short time, it's not as bad. It's when it becomes really, for some reason, you hit a certain point, like 30 minutes, and it really starts to dig in, I guess you could say. So there's video game addiction. And, you know, there's gambling. And I think that, I don't think there should be gambling. I know it can be a pastime for some people. My wife can go and gamble and take $50 or $100 and then that's it. And other people can't. So again, I think there is some genetics involved, chemical makeup, you know, something that predestines certain people's minds or bodies. I guess you would say the mind more than just the body. Well, the body, it's all kind of one thing anyway. You know, predestines them to be more susceptible to becoming an addict to certain things than other people. So, besides whatever genetic or chemical or, you know, predestined makeup someone might have that might make them, you know, become more easily an addict than someone else, there's also the aspect about those who become addicts to make up for something that maybe they're missing, or depression, or, you know, self-conscious reasons, peer pressure. You know, there's so many things out there that people deal with, why they maybe overeat, or why they are addicted to overeating, or to eating, addicted to exercising too much, to gambling. So while we have the aspect as far as what people's, you know, DNA and chemical aspects are, and mental aspects are, we have the emotional side, right? The emotional side that people eat and are addicted to video games or addicted to, you know, these various, or even drugs. You know, I think a lot of us, I think, have depression in some way. And a lot of us have, I think, society puts a lot of pressure on us because, you know, we have to have a job to eat. And everyone's, you know, most people want to have a nice, happy, comfortable life. And in order to do that, you need money, unfortunately. That's my problem with money and capitalism and economics, is that it really only helps those who, the system only helps those who have enough money to benefit from it. If you don't have a lot of money, you're not going to have good health care. You're not going to have a good place to live, you know, things like, not that those things are important. Well, health care is important, at least here in the United States, but those pressures, I think, can lead to addictions. People finding ways to make themselves happy, unfortunately, sometimes are drugs. I mean, a lot of us are fortunate. I think some of us, not so much. We are all born. We have no choice. We're born into our situations. I mean, I could have easily have been born into a, you know, third world country, or into a
try to find their happiness any way they can, and it ends up leading to drugs. Or alcoholism. You know, those things that are provide an instant escape. Or gambling. You know, gambling too. Besides the, you know, there's the instant gratification, there's the escape from our problems. And I think that condemns society to a degree. We need to be there in person. We need to find a way to be physically there for people, for one another. And that's hard. It's easy for me to say that. And I don't know everybody's situation. There's plenty of people out there that work in soup kitchens and volunteer, or work in poor areas of, you know, of like, say, Jamaica. You know, everyone likes to go to Jamaica for vacation. But to get the good parts, you gotta go through the slums. And my father, actually, who's a Christian man, and I respect him for that, even though I don't practice, he had it in him to volunteer to fly down with these brothers who volunteer their lives to help young adults who are who suffer physical disabilities, mental disabilities, and are left on the streets. And people, you know, if in I think in Jamaica, I forget where it was, but people who, whether it's their sons or daughters or brothers, their family members, they dump them on the streets like that. And so there's this brotherhood, so to speak, that takes them in and gives them a lot of special cares and attention and all that. So, but I think if we were there physically for each other and did away with all these things in society, money, you know, cut back on the time we spend at jobs so we can have more time in our personal lives, and thus more time for each other. Because right now, how many people work at least 8 hours, if not more, or two jobs, just to afford a living? So you have, and I know we're getting off topic here, but I think this is kind of a valid point in regards to addiction and looking for that. What's going to fill us up that's missing in our lives. And so we all have the right to live our lives and be happy. And that's great. And so we work more than we probably should. And we have, what little time we have left is time for ourselves or our families. And that's understandable. But we should have more time, so that we have time for ourselves and time for our neighbors and strangers, so that we're not strangers, so that we're more of a global community, you know, that we're not, you know, we're there to help people, and people don't have to go see psychiatrists or go to double E meetings, you know, or struggle with addictions. And I think there needs to be more love, more, you know, community. And, you know, that's one thing. I think a lot of our issues with addiction, with society, is how we're not really close as we should be. We are a collective of individuals. And, you know, I find out who I am and the meaning of life. And I met my wife, we had a kid, and now a family to take care of. And so, you know, I'm as guilty as anyone. But I think we're all in this together. We're born into the situation. The situation needs to change. It needs to get better. And so I think that would go a long way to helping people with addictions, getting rid of some of these things. You know, like, we know that alcoholism is a problem, but yet, you know, on TV, it's sex and alcohol on the ads and drugs. Sex, drugs, and, you know, so you shouldn't be watching TV either. And I don't watch TV anyway, except for The Walking Dead. And cartoons. And, yeah, so I think that aside from condemning the world like I just did, I mean, I'm sure you guys know what I mean. Guys and gals out there, you know what I mean. We have a long ways to go, I think, as a species, and we could do a lot better. I think we might get there. I think a lot has to change, though. But yeah, but as far as addictions, you know, it doesn't help when people are addicted to cigarettes, and instead of just getting rid of the cigarettes, you know, don't sell them anymore. You know, we keep raising taxes. We know cigarettes. People enjoy smoking them. Okay, that's fine. But I don't know. I don't want to get into every little addiction itself so much, because you could spend hours just talking about them. Anyway, I think there needs to be more of an effort by society to help those who have addictions by somehow limiting the things that cause them to be addicted in the first place, you know. I don't know how you do that. You can't fix people. You can't just alter their DNA or, you know, make them happy. But, you know, maybe the industries, well, they'll never take responsibility, but if certain stores stopped selling cigarettes or alcohol, but then you have people like me who drink, do enjoy, yet I'm not addicted or an alcoholic. So that's not a good decision. So I don't know what the answer is. Yeah, so it's people need help, and, you know, we need to find a way to figure out why so many people are addicted to things, and what we need to do as a society to help them besides just sending them to a meeting or a psychiatrist. And I think also as parents, I think a lot of that plays into it. I think we need to make sure we are good parents to our children, and make sure we limit exposure to video games, make sure we are there for our children, or even our other family members. You know, make sure we are there for each other. Kind of goes back to my whole thing about, you know, this whole global community being there for each other. You know, a lot of addictions may stem from childhood, responsible if they only have children, but it's the parents that, you know, abuse or leave the kid not be, you know, I think you know what I'm trying to say. You know, they leave, they want to deal with a child for selfish reasons. There are parents maybe that cannot afford to raise a child or do not have the ability to properly raise a child that give the children up for adoption. I'm talking about parents that are not there for the kids because they would rather be at the bar with their friends or, you know, or shopping or whatever, and they leave the kid home to be babysat by the video game. Or, you know, and that leads to, you know, that can lead to things, but, you know, I that wasn't my case. My parents were there for me, and I've been playing games since the Atari 2600, so it's addiction is not really a simple cut and dry thing, to deal with. I mean, I've been playing video games forever, and a lot of what I've gone through and learned about myself as I grow older is self-control. It's a very, you know, anybody out there who is an addict to anything, you feel comfortable, you know, drop a comment and, you know, lend some insight into, you know, why you may have become addicted to something. And are you still addicted? Are you still struggling? Are you over your addiction? Because I can speak to the video game and the computer aspect. Never really became addicted to cigarettes or alcohol, so I really can't speak to that. Or cocaine or heroin, so I can't speak to those either, you know. I think we have a chemical physical makeup that predestines certain people to be prone to becoming addicts than others. I think that's part of it, and I think the other part is how we're raised, maybe. The environment we're raised in, the people we hang out with, the friends, the choices we make, the society we live in as far as capitalism. There's so many factors that play a role, I think, that you can't really just isolate one and say, we're gonna ban cigarettes, because that's not, what's that gonna do? That's gonna make cigarettes illegal, and then people are gonna find a way to buy them. And there's gotta be more nurturing, right? Somehow. That's the only thing I can think of, because you can't take away the objects, because people will find a way to find another addiction. So there's got to be something that we can do as a community for one another, to help one another, you know? So, yeah, that's we could talk hours, and I don't really know what else I could, any other angles I can talk about on that. We could talk about sex addiction, and you know, that's you know, or food addiction. That's instant gratification. But you know, and that's making up for something, some kind of hole, HOLE, an empty void in our lives, whatever that might be. And I think that's, you know, a lot of addictions are like that, trying to find happiness in the wrong places, in the wrong ways. So I think that's really all I got on that subject. Would like to hear from anyone what you think, again, and then I think I'll hit on, you know, some of the, again, leave, if you have more, you know, Q&A subjects, let me know. But I want to do the highest upvoted comment will be next subject, or if now there's more than one, if there's no highest upvoted one, you know, I'll just pick a bunch. But you know, this is just a impromptu, relaxed kind of session, so there's no really rules or anything. So we're just taking it as we go here. So again, as always, thanks for watching. Yeah, until next time, stay relaxed.